Alright folks, how you guys doing? This is going to be the Goodwood Mods do-it-yourself walkthrough, and we're going to do the full review as we always do it. So this first part is going to be the walkthrough. I'm going to show you what comes in the box when you get it. Then I'm going to switch camera angles and set up. Then I want to actually show you how to install one of these Goodwood Mods pads, because it would take me a long time to do all four. But by showing you how to do one, you just repeat the process and do the same thing over again. So first, let me show you what you get. First of all, when you get the box, you get four of these brand new do-it-yourself Goodwood Mods pads. Now, Rich has told me that a lot of improvements have been made. They have piezos that's being specially made for them and foam now, and it does actually look a whole lot better and a lot different than the first kit that I got, which is the first production kit. All right, so as you can see here in the center, it does, if you have the original kit, it does have a different foam. It's a bigger, rounder piece of foam now versus the little square piece that came with the original. So this is what it looks like. Here is the wire right here that you're going to use. It's going to connect in, and at the bottom, as you can see, it's labeled with an arrow. So it's labeled R and an arrow of which way that this pad is supposed to go up. So that way, when you do and you install the pad, you know which part of this is supposed to be up, and you can install it correctly. So you get four of these. It looks just like this. It's going to be labeled for the individual drum on the back accordingly. I know you can't see it really good, but there's also the holes already indented in here for you of where the feet from the original pads go. So we're getting to that when I install it, okay? Get four of those. He's also going to send you a bag of screws. These are flathead screws that he's asking you and telling you that it's better to use these to replace with the Phillips head screws that come out of the feet. So he sends you these. We'll get into that in a minute. I've already cut this in preparation for you guys, but you get a block of foam with the lines on it so that you can cut out the squares. Four pieces of this is going to go underneath the drum before you put the Goodwood Mods on for extra stability. And you can glue that in, which you see me Gorilla Glue mine, and that's all going to be when we go through the walkthrough of that. As well as he gives you his famous Goodwood Mods struts that goes up underneath just like it did in the regular kit. This is going to take a little bit more weight off of the Goodwood Mods drums, because being that they're solid wood, they're all a little heavier than what the stock kit is. Okay, so that's it. It looks pretty simple. Oh, plus he gives you an instruction sheet. So a little square instruction sheet that I don't have with me. I think I left it over my desk. And then the instructions that tells you exactly how to do this. But if you get stuck when you're doing this, you can just come back, watch this video. Rich is also working on a video to put up on the Goodwood Mods side of this, so this should help you out, all right? So give me a second. I'm going to switch camera angles, bring my little table over here so we can set up, and I'm going to walk you through how to do one of these pads. So I'll be back and see you in just a second. All right, welcome back. We're going to go through the installation of one of the pads. I have the red pad already taken off. This is actually what the red pad looks like. I've taken the feet and everything off already when it's taken off. What I'm going to attempt to do, for those of you who don't know how to do this, see if I can do this from a sitting down position, is I'm going to go ahead and also try to pull off the yellow pad. What you're going to do is your fingers needs to go in between the rim and the drum itself. So the rim here and then the drum underneath. And you got to give it a firm tug with not too much pressure, because you don't want to rip the cord out. So basically, you gotta get up underneath there and you have to put a lot of pressure on it, like that. Now, I've lubed mine down a couple, so it might be a little easier. Just go around and do the same thing, just like so, until it all pops off. If underneath, this is what you're gonna have. You have the wire here that's connected, okay? And then, so you just pull this wire out. Well, this would work better with some needle noses, but I don't have any with me right now. And this is what it actually looks like. Here in the middle is what your sensor is, the four pieces of protective foam they put around there to give it a little cushion, and then the four feet that we're going to be using in the Goodwood Mods kit. So this is what your head looks like, and that's how easy it is to pop off. So we're going to install the red head today. So what we're going to first do is we're going to take these four feet that I just showed you, and we're going to install those first with the screws that we're taking out that Rich and Paul from Goodwood Mods has already sent us to do the job with. Now right here is the two holes of where these go. They're all marked out according to what the pad is that you're doing the installation with. So all I'm going to do is take my screwdriver. You need a small screwdriver. You have an electric one, it'd be probably best to use, as there are slot screws, but or flathead screws, but mine is all dead, so I'm stuck with the manual. So we have one or the other. What I'm going to do is go ahead and put the feet position just like it is with the holes, because he's already got all this mapped out. What I'm going to do is I like to drop my screws in first so I can actually feel the holes when I get in there, and then I'll go ahead and line it up with the holes that Rich has drawn for me already. Like so, and they fit right in there just like that. Then you want to go ahead and just screw those down. Be careful, watch the slips. And this isn't the world's best screwdriver, but it's the smallest one that I have for now at the time being. All right, so now we got that in there. Okay, and you're going to repeat that for all four. Just right in the holes he has them, you repeat that around for all four of the pieces. Okay, once again, just for time's sake, I'll do one more for you. These screws he recommends you use because they are a little bit longer than the screws that comes with the actual kit. This is a QM kit, by the way, so the QM kit is a little bit harder to pull apart. Well, you might want to go ahead and lube that down a little bit with some Vaseline like I did at first. Go ahead and hold that in there. Make sure I got it in the hole. It's kind of hard to do. I'm trying to show you guys. I'm just going to see the hole. Alright, now through the magic video editing and all that good stuff, I now have all 4 feet ready to go on the Goodwood Mods Stealth Head. Before I go on, I want to show you this too. When I pulled off the yellow one, the rubber foot popped off. This can happen. It's very easy. All you're going to do is just take the ring it comes out of and just insert this back from the bottom, like so. And that's it, it's back in there, so it's ready to go. So just in case that happens to you. All right, what I should have done before is went ahead and glued these foam pieces down so they could be dry. But I use Gorilla Glue, and Gorilla Glue dries very well. And glue is optional, but I'm gonna use glue on mine because I wanna make sure that they're in there and it's not gonna give me any problems when I'm trying to put the actual pad in by moving around and so on and so forth. So this is what we're going to do. Piece of the foam goes at the top here, then at the bottom, then on both sides. Okay, this is just for extra stability. And so just like on the yellow one, same way, top, bottom, and to the side. So what I'm going to do is take a little bit of Gorilla Glue. If you use Gorilla Glue, keep in mind that you don't have to use very much because it does expand. Okay, so 4 per drum. I'm gonna put one here, I'm gonna put one here, and one there, just to hold it in place.